The Kirrup Pentecostal Empowerment Ministries International of 27 McDonald Street, Kirrup, Trinidad, West Indies presents Empowerment Through the Word. Come with us as we affect humanity with the life-transforming power of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. We invite you to stay tuned and be blessed.
Who is he? Who's the mightiest of all? Who is he? Creation trembles at his call. Who is he? The lowly sacrifice who paid a victim's price. His name is Jesus. Jesus from the Father's own right hand. Jesus, Son of God and Son of Man. Jesus, who died and rose again. Jesus, he's the Lion and the Lamb. Who is he with the power none can tame? Who is he that every foe would fear his name? Who is he who was humbly led away to suffer that dark day? His name is Jesus. Jesus from the Father's own right hand. And rose again. Jesus, he's the Lion and the Lamb. He's the Lion and the
praise the Lord. A pleasant good morning to you and greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I trust that you are continuing to pray, to call upon God, to petition God, to act on the acts. You see, action, adoring him, confessing our sins where we have failed, giving thanks, and then bringing our needs before him. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. This is time for us to trust again and to hope again, and to believe again, and to call upon God again. What a joy it is to come into your homes, into your cars, into your hotel rooms, if you are there. Yes, it's not easy now, but God remains good. He's a good God. He's the great I am that I am. call upon him now, even now. He loves you with an everlasting love. Thank you for the privilege of coming to you again. I praise God for you. Thank you for your prayerful support. We cannot go out now, but we can still communicate with him. Nobody can hinder or obstruct that line. Glory be to God. It's open 24/7. To God be the glory. Would you call on him now? Oh God, I thank you for allowing me to see another day. I give you praise. It is of your mercies that we are not consumed, because your compassions, they fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Thank you. Thank you, you who keep Israel, will never slumber nor sleep. You do not grow weary. Hallelujah. Blessed be his wonderful name forever and ever. Thank God. Well, we want this day to look at this week, because it's traditionally called Passion Week, Palm Sunday. Jesus Christ, traditionally, this is the time, this is the week, Passion Week, yes, where he will be crucified. The Son of God, who became the Son of Man for you and for me, came to die. I want to read this morning from John, the 19th chapter, from the 28th verse. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, said, "I thirst." Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar and put it upon hyssop and put it to his mouth. When Jesus, therefore, had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. It is finished. What a statement. The four evangelists, mainly Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, they emphasize something that is very, very important. We find in the book of Matthew, the 25th chapter, Matthew chapter 25, or Matthew 27 rather, and verse number 35, three pertinent words. What are they? Matthew 27:35, Mark 15:25, Luke 23:33, and John 19:18. Three important words. And what are they? In these verses, they crucified him. They crucified him. they crucified him. John 19:18, they crucified him. Very, very important to the believer, to Christianity, to the world. This is how we are able to resonate the John 3:16, for God so loved the world. But I read John 19:28-30, because I want to emphasize the fact of his purpose for coming. Notice what he said. It is finished. It is finished. In other words, expiration has occurred. Accomplishment has taken place. There is no more adding to it, and no one can take out or take away from it. It is fully and completely satisfied. God is pleased, in other words. The question, it is finished. I want to say, it is not the moan of the defeated. Neither is it the sigh of the patient resignation. In other words, thank God, it's over. We can't even say now, thank God, it's Friday, because we're all out. We're all home. Even though we want to say it. But no. But it is the cry of the victor with victory on his lips. It is the triumphant recognition that Jesus has fully accomplished the work that he came to do. He made it clear in John the 4th chapter and the 34th verse. My meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. John 17:4. Father, I have finished the work that thou gavest me to do. That's the Lord's Prayer. Matthew chapter 6 from verse 9 or thereabouts. That's the model prayer. John 17, it's the Lord's Prayer. He's talking to the Father. He is laying out all that he's come to do, what he's able to accomplish for the glory of God. He says in John 6:38, I came down from heaven not to do my will, but the will of him that sent me. Praise be unto God. He came to fully accomplish the work that he was able to perform. But let's move on. It is finished. What is finished? Well, firstly, the law is fulfilled as never before and never since in his obedience unto death, even the death of the cross. the Apostle Paul in the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, from the first verse. Hallelujah. There is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in that it was weak in the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of flesh, sinful flesh, and for man, condemn sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Romans, the 8th chapter, from the first verse unto the 4th. For the law made nothing perfect, but the bringing in of a better hope did. Hebrews chapter 6 and verse number 19. Colossians 2:13-15. And he took it, the commandments, and nailed it to the cross. Yes, the law is fulfilled. It is finished, fully accomplished, what Jesus did on the cross of Calvary. Secondly, messianic prophecy is fulfilled and accomplished. Luke 24:27-44. The scriptures, Jesus said, they testify of me, all that is in the law and in the Psalms and in the prophets, they speak of me. So Jesus was able to tell the hearers, search the scriptures, John chapter 5 and verse number 39. For in them you think you have eternal life, and the scriptures, they testify of me. Thirdly, when we say it is finished, when Jesus cried, it is finished, he is saying, I have finished the transgression and made an end of sin. Oh, Isaiah beheld him some 650 years before he came on the scene. He says in Isaiah 53, who had believed a report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of a dry ground. He had no form nor comeliness, and when we look at him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. He was despised, and yet we esteemed him not. But surely he had borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Praise God. Hallelujah. To the Lord God of heaven and earth. who loved us so much to give to us his only begotten son. When he gave Jesus, he gave all. He gave his best. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Hallelujah. Yes, it is finished. So hence the reason John the Baptist was able to look on Jesus. According to John chapter 1 and verse number 29, behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Indeed he did. So now man can live forevermore because he came. He came. It is finished. Fourthly, the scaffolding of an ancient economy is broken down. That's right. Everything now has come down. Everything that we wanted to hold on to has come down. God made Jesus Christ to be sin for us. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse number 21. God made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Blessed be the wonderful name of the Lord. Yes, the scaffolding, everything, you put the scaffold up, and then because the job is finished, completed, you're taking it down. Yes, everything. The Bible tells us, according to Matthew 27, 51 to 53, there was darkness from the sixth to the ninth hour. The veil of the temple was rent in twain from the top to the bottom. Now it was very high. Man could not have done that. It is only God. Now we can enter into the Holy of Holies. The Bible tells us we can come boldly to the throne of grace, that we can obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Praise God. It is finished. Great accomplishment through our Lord Jesus Christ. But not only that, it is finished. What do we find? He has given birth to a new world order. That's right. Birth to a new world order. Introducing the born again experience. Except a man be born again, he cannot see, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. He came for purpose. To destroy. 1 John chapter 3 and verse 8. For this purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. And this morning, he's calling on us. Will you accept the sacrifice of my only begotten Son, Jesus? He came and he paid the price for your sins and for mine. It is finished. He's introduced a new world order, the new birth. And you can experience that this morning by simply calling upon him, asking him to forgive you of your sins, because sin must be destroyed. Sin must be judged, for God is a holy God and he cannot look upon sin. The Bible tells us God sent him into the world not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed on the only begotten Son of God. This morning, the opportunity is yours. It's ours to call upon him. Will you do that? They crucified him, not for himself, not that he could not have done better, but he came for this purpose, to die for you and for me. What a message. What a God. Will you pray with me this morning? Those of us who have never asked him to come into our lives. You've never surrendered. You've never submitted. Will you do that now? Especially in these times. Pray with me, please. Oh God, I repent of my sins because I am a sinner. In need of you, Lord Jesus, as my Savior. Forgive me now. Wash me in your precious blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary for my sins. Come into my life and save me. I confess you now as my Savior and as my Lord. And I believe in my heart that you're alive and alive forevermore. Thank you for saving me now and writing my name in your book of life. Amen. Let me pray for you now. Thank you, Father, for showing yourself strong on our behalf, by sending Jesus Christ, who paid the price for our sins. Oh God, because of this, all things are possible. And I bless you for meeting every need of those calling upon you now. Healing, deliverance, security, safety, and peace. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Well, enjoy the rest of your week. Spend time in prayer with Almighty God. Remember to get us on Facebook. Yes, you can do that. On YouTube also, as we continue to bring the Word of God. We're not going under. No, 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 no. Because Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. God bless you and your household. Have a great week.